We all learn Newton's laws in high school. We have to memorize them and practice them and apply them, blah, blah, blah. But what we don't learn is why they were important, why they were revolutionary, and why we even care. So here I am. I want to go through Newton's three laws of motion in a slightly unexpected way. First, let's start off with the first law because, you know, it's the first law. The first law states that an object at rest tends to stay at rest, and an object in motion prefers to stay in motion. Sounds like pretty like lame and not interesting at all, but this is actually entirely counterintuitive to how we actually perceive the world around us. And when Newton proposed this in the late 1600s, it ran counter to decades, centuries, millennia of philosophical thought of how the universe worked. Prior to Newton's laws, we had assumed that motion was an intrinsic property of an object, or the preference for motion was an intrinsic property of an object. Like rocks prefer to stay still because that is a property of rockiness. So if I kick it, of course it's going to slow down because it doesn't like to move and it's eventually going to rest, stop moving again. But I don't know, the wind likes to move, and if I try to stop it, it will work around me. It'll go through my fingers, it'll go around my body, and it'll keep on moving because wind is a kind of thing that likes to keep moving. Newton threw this all out the window. He said, no, it's not a preference for motion or immobility that is intrinsic property to an object. All objects have a resistance to motion. They have something we call inertia. And because of this inertia, once an object, it takes effort, it takes energy to get an object into motion. And then once it's moving, it takes effort, it takes energy to slow it down. This is counterintuitive because, hey, I kick the rock and it slows down on its own. What gives, Newton? Why are you saying this? Well, Newton says, no, look. Once you've kicked the rock, the rock would prefer to stay in motion, but something else is slowing it down. There's something called friction. There's a new force. There's energy being applied that is making the rock slow down. But without that friction, the rock would just keep on going. This is weird and counterintuitive, and it's his first law. The second law is that force equals mass times acceleration. That if you apply a force to an object, it will accelerate, and the amount of its acceleration depends on its mass. This writing of force equals mass times acceleration is really the conservation of momentum, the principle of conservation of momentum, written in a different way. Conservation of momentum is perhaps the most important cornerstone concept in all of physics. Every single branch of physics is really an expression of momentum conservation. Not just Newton's laws, but general relativity, special relativity, quantum mechanics, quantum electrodynamics, thermodynamics, electromagnetism. It's everything is really an expression of conservation momentum. And the first person to write it down in a consistent, coherent way was Newton, right there with force equals mass times acceleration. The third law is that every force has an equal and opposite force opposing it. And again, this flies in the face of common sense, right? If I push a book, I am applying a force to that book and the book is accelerating. Okay, whatever, no big deal. But Newton's saying, oh, as I'm pushing on the book is also pushing back on me. But I'm like, wait a minute, I don't have an acceleration. The book is the one moving, not me. So what gives? How can these be in balance? How can there be any motion at all? Newton says, look to the second law for a clue. I push on the book. It has a little bit of mass. That gives it a big acceleration. The book is also applying a force to me, but I have a bigger mass than the book, so my acceleration is very small. The forces are in balance, but not necessarily the accelerations. This is important, this equal and opposite. This is important because it teaches us that forces never come alone. For every force, there is another force paired to it. And in fact, once you think about it, if you're pushing on a book or a couch or something, you feel a resistance. You feel something pressing into your skin. That is the force applied by the book or the couch or the object back on you. You feel it. Without that force applying back to you, you wouldn't feel anything. So those are Newton's three laws. And with just those three laws, he was able to unlock just about everything. He was able to explain so much about the natural world using just these three laws. That's what gave Newton's work so much power. That's what made it the cornerstone of physics for over 200 years. In fact, the cornerstone of the physics of your everyday life. So, thanks, Newton. I'll see you next week. And don't forget, you can contribute to patreon.com/pmstutter. I really do appreciate it. Like, share, subscribe or not. Leave a comment or not. Go watch another video or not. Just live your life and enjoy those three laws. And I'll see you next week.